Hello, this is Willie Carpenter with APA Home Inspection LLC. I've been noticing lately that since we've converted over to an online inspection request form, that there have been some confusion about how to fill out the form, or some things have been missing off of the form, not being filled out properly, therefore causing a little bit of a stir at the time of inspection. So what I wanted to do tonight is give everyone a brief tutorial on how to properly fill out the APA home inspection request form. All right, so this won't take up much of your time. I just wanted to just kind of spend a few minutes with you to break down the basics. Now, what I'm gonna do is share my screen with you. All right, now the first thing we do is we go to apahi.net. That's apahi.net. Okay, now once we are here, the next thing we want to do is click on the request and inspection tab. Okay, request and inspection tab, which is right here. Okay. Once we click on that, then we go through the motions of filling out the form. Now, it's a total of 7 pages, with one page being a review page. But I want to walk through each of these pages just to give you a quick way on how to fill out a form so that we don't miss any information. All right, the first thing you see with the asterisk is by address. The first thing we want to do is we want to put the address down. Okay, let's say, for example, we're using 104 Tall Pines Road. Okay, so if we are setting up an inspection for that, we would type in the address. As you can see, it's gotten into 2, but you don't have to do that. You can erase that and put everything. You can put everything right there. Okay, Tall Pines Road, that's fine. You don't have to fill out the address number 2, only if there's like an apartment number, then you can put that apartment number there, okay? Fill in the city of Ladson, the state, okay? South Carolina, okay? The county, if you know the county, please insert the county. Tall Pines is probably Dorchester. Dorchester. Okay, Dorchester County, the country, of course, USA, all right? Next, you have a map down here. Normally, if you put your address in, it normally pops up on the Google Maps here, okay? You can use that, but you don't have to use that. Additional directions, I encourage you, if you are requesting an inspection in a new construction. A lot of times when new constructions with brand new roads, you cannot pick it up on GPS. I find the houses that I inspect through my GPS system. But if you are in a new neighborhood or you're in new construction and you've got a brand new street, Google has not had a chance to add you to their inventory. Therefore, I suggest that you right here, on the page where it says additional directions, add some notes. You might want to say, you know, give me some landmarks, like this is the main road is near, 178 or, you know, Highway 78. Put some additional directions to help me find a place, especially if it's a new construction. Because if I try to type in the address, it will not do it. For new construction, what you could do in the additional directions, just state that it is new construction and maybe put the address of the house that they use for a model, the model house. And usually the model house will come up on GPS. So please fill all that information in. Now, once we've got the address in, that's step number 1, then we click down here where my cursor is and go to next. Okay. Next is the email of the property buyer. the email of the property buyer. So you would put their email in here. I'll use mine, for example, first and last name. Okay, please put that in there. Mobile number. If you have a mobile number for your client, it's important that you add the mobile number, because if there is an issue, I may need to call them directly. Okay, if there's an issue with billing, if there's an issue with an address or a time or whatever the case may be, I may need to contact them. So please make sure that you insert a mobile number if you have it. I'll put mine in there just to have a number in there, okay? You can add their state, their city, wherever they're living now, that's fine, okay? There's a skip button here, but please do not skip this because this is necessary. Property buyer or the property seller, where I need to have that information. Most of the time when I do an inspection is for buyers. But if a person is selling the house, then I would need to know that too. Where it says address 1 and 2, they're talking about the address that they are living now, not talking about the property address that they want to inspect. It says address of where the person is living now, not where they are wanting to inspect. Now, if the person wants me to inspect the house that they are living in, because sometimes I get people ask me to do an inspection on the house that they are selling and they're still living in the house, then you would put that address right there. It would be the same as the address that's of the property that's being inspected, okay? Property details. It says here, all details are optional. I would prefer that you put all the details possible. All right, the year built. If it was built in 1960, it tells me that it's 61 years old, okay? A lot of times I inspect houses that are older than 25 years old. I need to know the date the house was built. Please make sure you do not skip that. How many bedrooms? If it's a 2-bedroom, 4-bedroom, please install that, okay? The property footage, please put 2,500 square foot. If you don't know the exact footage, I need to know as close as you possibly can, because all of that plays a part in the billing process, okay? The year and the square footage are the two main things that play a part in the billing process. Okay, full baths. If it's got 2 baths, that's fine. If it's got a half bath, put that in there, please. The MLS number, now that is optional. I don't necessarily need the MLS number. If you have it, please add it. If you don't have it, I'm okay with that either way, okay? Is the property right here? Property is occupied or vacant? Please, please fill this out. Let me know whether or not the property is occupied. If it's occupied, that means that someone is living in the house. If the house is being rented, I need you to put occupied. If the owner is still living in the house, please put occupied there, because I need to know how to prepare for this inspection. Okay. If the house is vacant, put that there. I need to know if no one is in the house. This is important information that helps protect me. I need to know this information. So please fill out whether the property is occupied or vacant. Okay, utilities on, very, very important. Real estate agents, if you are setting up this inspection for your client, or you're having them set the inspection up for themselves, please make sure that all of the utilities are on. Make sure the water is on, make sure the electricity is on, make sure the gas is on, okay? If these items are not on and I come out to the house, I would have to charge you a rescheduling fee. Okay. And that is an $85 plus tax fee. Nobody wants to pay $85 for me to come back out because utilities were not on. So please make sure when you are doing the inspection form that you highlight whether the services are on and just click on, okay? And I'm gonna click here that it's vacant. And as far as the property occupied or vacant, in these particular times, it would be nice if the house is vacant. Now, I know all the time that's not a choice, but if I had a choice, I would much rather the house be vacant because it's safer for everyone involved. But I know that's not always possible, but vacant is always preferred, okay? Who will be present at the inspection? If the buyer is going to be there, fill that out. If you are the buyer's agent, please say yes, you'll be there. If the seller is going to be there, fill that out. Okay. If the seller's agent is going to be there, fill that out as well. Please, that's important. I need to know who all is going to be there. That's for my safety and for theirs. If somebody is saying that they're supposed to be at the inspection but not there, I should be able to ask questions like, okay, well, what happened? Why aren't they there? Sometimes accidents happen and nobody knows what happened. So it's a safety issue. So please make sure that you fill out who all is going to be at the inspection, okay? Pet instructions at the bottom of the page. If an animal is going to be in the house, I need to know this. If a dog, cat, squirrel, rabbit, whatever animal is in that house, me as the inspector, I need to know for my protection, okay? I'm not scared of dogs, but sometimes dogs are mean, all right? And I want to make sure that I stay protected. I may have a helper with me. You know, I don't know what the reaction is going to be. So I just need a heads up, okay? Just give me a heads up so I know how to prepare myself in the event that an animal is there. So just put something like, the dogs will be in cages at the time of inspection, okay? So that gives me a heads up. Okay, now I know the dogs are going to be there, okay? Now we're going to go next. Now, available services. I want to take my time with this one because we've been having a little bit of confusion about inspection services for APA. Now, this is what we do. These are the service groups, okay? Inspection services for APA home inspection. Those are my residential inspections, okay? Commercial inspections. If you have a business that needs to be inspected, that includes churches, hair salons, even if it's a barber shop or some type of business where some type of building where business is going to be taking on, I'm going to have to inspect it. I have commercial inspections for that. Okay. As you may or may not know, I also do mold inspections. I'm certified to take air quality samples and take mold samples. Microbial growth. I can take these samples to test and see if they're mold. I can test the air to see how high the mold spores are in the air. I can do those things. So if you need a mold inspection or mold testing, air quality testing services, that's here, commercial and inspection. So most of the time when you come to my site, you're looking for a home inspection. So you would hit this one right here. All right. And I need you to scroll all the way down and look at all of the services. Okay. I have the services broke down according to square footage. All right. The bigger the house, the longer it takes me to inspect it. And that causes the charge to increase by the size of the house. Okay. That's standard for any well-trained inspector. They charge according to the square footage of the house. So you go down here, you say, let's say that the house is almost 2,800 square foot or so. So I click this plus sign right here. All right. Now, scroll down. I also offer wind mitigation inspection. residential crawl space inspection. If the house has a crawl space, you have to select residential crawl space inspection, okay? Because that is a separate charge for me to go under the house and investigate what's going on under the house. Please make sure that if the house has a crawl space, that you highlight or hit the plus sign so that is added. I need to have the right equipment to prepare for that. So I need to know in advance if we are doing a residential crawl space inspection. So please check that out. If it has a crawl space, check that, okay? A full point inspection, I do those. Just checking major points. Add on residential inspection of a property that's 25 to 49 years old, okay? If your property that you want me to inspect is over 25 to 49 years old, that's an additional add-on. Okay, that's a $45 add-on. If it's 50 years old to 100 years old, and I have inspected houses that was 100 years old, that is going to be an additional fee. Now, why isn't it an additional fee for the age? Because it takes more time to inspect a house that's that old. There are more issues, and it requires a different skill set from me as an inspector to inspect an older home. I cannot inspect a home that is 100 years old the way that I would inspect a house that is, say, 10 or 15 years old. There is a difference there. So please make sure you enter the year the house was built. All right, I just want to make sure you get the best inspection service possible. Next, under the 50 years old add-on, look at this. The add-on for additional building or a detached garage. If the home that you want me to inspect has a detached garage, I need to know that. Please highlight that in the form. Just hit the plus sign, okay? A lot of times the garages are not attached to the house. Sometimes the garages are by themselves. That is a separate building, okay? Please highlight that on the inspection form so I know how to approach that inspection, okay? And another reason is when it's a separate building, it takes longer for me to inspect the property because a smaller building would have the same properties as a larger building. It's just smaller, okay? So it's gonna take more time. So please make sure that you highlight the detached garage or an additional building. If you want me to inspect a shed of some sort, someplace used for just storing things, if you want me to inspect that is not attached to the house, please, you have to hit that right there, okay? Reinspection. If I do an inspection on the house and the repairs have been made and you want me to come back out, you go to the reinspection service for a residential property that's less than 2,100 feet without a crawl space. So if you want me to do an inspection of a house of that size or any reinspection, I'll adjust that later, but any reinspection of a house that does not have a crawl space, you need to hit the first one for the 125 add-on. If it's a reinspection of a house with a crawl space, that's 175. That's not just an add-on. That's not an add-on. That is a specific inspection. Whether it's a reinspection of a house without a crawl space or one with a crawl space, those are separate inspections. Now, to make it easier, you might want to suggest to your client to go ahead and get the you can pay for the reinspection in advance, okay? Once you get the inspection, you can pay for the reinspection so that you don't have to pay later, you can pay for it now. That way, when I do the inspection report and I send it out, you've already paid for the reinspection, so as soon as I receive the repair addendum or the list of things that's been repaired, I can go back out and I would not have to charge you again because you've already paid for it at the time when you paid for your original inspection. Okay. So you have that option, but my reinspection prices are right there. All right. And that's where we are with that. Now, if you want to add on a mold inspection service, that's $275. Say that you have a house and you want me to go ahead and do an air quality test and inspect for mold in the house as well. That's an additional $275, which I suggest you do if you suspect mold activity in the house. Okay. If you have a duplex that the total building size is less than 2,100 total square feet without a crawl space, that's $575. Anything larger than that, give me a call and I can give you additional pricing for that. Just give me a call depending on what it is. All right. Last but not least, I have a return visit or a rescheduling fee of $85. So if in the event, now let me show you what that covers. If I were, or one of the APA inspectors, if we come out to the house, okay, and a utility is not on, and I have to, or one of the inspectors have to come out again or reschedule, that's an $85 fee. Even if I have to come back the same day, that is still a charge because that is time taken away that I could have been somewhere else helping somebody with their inspection and getting paid for that. So it takes time, it takes gas, it takes material to get to your inspection, okay? If the utilities are not on, or if there is another scheduling issue that does not have anything to do with the utilities. I've been to an inspection once where the person that was in the house didn't know I was coming. Somebody didn't tell them that I was coming through. So I had to reschedule. That is a fee for that, okay? And it's called the return visit or rescheduling fee, okay? So all that is there, all right? And then when you go down to the bottom here, my commercial, and my mold inspection and testing services are there as well. Everything is drawn out for you, okay? You simply come here, choose the inspections that you require, okay? Next, hit the next button. So you get to choose up to two dates which you can choose for the inspection. Okay, normal hours of operation are right there, between 8 to 6 p.m. Monday through Saturday. Okay, that's our normal business hours right there. All right, so if you want to do this on the 28th and any time of day, or you can prefer morning, afternoon, or evening. You want afternoon on that day, or you say you can't do it that day, you can do it on the 29th. And it can be in the morning. However you want to do that, you get up to 2 days to choose what time is best for you, whether that's afternoon or morning. I'll determine the time once I get the request, okay? Hit the next button. Page 6 or step 6 of 7. Here is a review page, okay? All that you are doing is just looking over everything that's there, all right? Right here where it says customer, that is the person whom is paying for the inspection. That's the customer. Right here, you can add the real estate professional. Whoever the real estate agent is, needs to be added here. And this is why, because when I schedule this, this real estate professional will also get a notification of when the inspection is going to take place. Okay, so please make sure that you add the real estate professional onto the home inspection request form, so I know who else is involved with this transaction so they can be notified, okay? If there's more than one customer, there may be a husband and a wife that both want to be notified. All that needs to be added right here where it says add customer or add real estate professional, okay? Change request, time and date, edit comments. If you need to add a comment, you can click right here and you can add that. If you realize that you made a mistake, you can click this, change the date and time. That's all right, okay? See right here, it says year built, 1960, square footage, just a review. This right here is a breakdown of all the services. This is all the services, and it totals everything up right down here. And all you, and once everything, okay, let's say you get to the, and you, before we go to request an appointment, let's say that you forgot to add something. You can go here and add or remove a service right down here in the lower left, okay? Now, once everything is where you need it, you've looked over everything and you say, all right, now I'm ready to send this off. Hit request an appointment. That's all you do. And I just got an email that a request for an inspection has been released. Now, what happens is when I receive this, I will send you out, I will send the customer a home inspection agreement. The agreement can be signed online. I will also send them the invoice for the inspection. The invoice can be paid online, okay? To make it convenient, everything in this transaction, as far as the scheduling, as far as the signing of agreement, and as far as the paying, all of that can be done online to make it easier for you and your clients, okay? Once I have sent out the, once I confirm the appointment, I will send it out via email, and you and your client will get the email notification of the exact time when the inspection is going to be, and who's doing the inspection. For right now, most of the time, it will be myself, okay? But everything is right there for you. And it'll say, thank you for requesting an appointment from APA Home Improvement and Inspections, LLC. You will receive a confirmation, okay? So that is how we fill out the form properly. I do this because I thought it was important for me to basically share with you what it looks like to to do the fill out the inspection form. All right. If you have any questions, you can still feel free to give me a call at 843-801-4098. You can give me a call. You can go to the website. You can send me a message at wcarpenter at APA, APAHI.net. That is fine. I do accept the emails, but everything is very simple. You know, I tried to streamline the site to make it as easy and as user-friendly as possible while maintaining a professional appearance to the public. Again, so thank you for your time. And this has been how to properly fill out the APA home inspection request form online. Thank you for your time.